to everyone. My topic is ocular axial end changes following trauma, blunt versus brain retina. I have no financial interest. Human eye is a very well programmed organ exhibiting a regulated growth pattern. Developing eye adjusts the growth of its refractive components to achieve emmetropization. An increase in ocular length and myopic shift has been observed following pediatric cataract extraction in many studies. Trauma, visual deprivation, surgery at an early age, multiple surgeries have been postulated as a cause of axial length elongation. So the aim of our study was to analyze the factors statistically associated with changes in axial length in traumatic eyes. So the methods was, it was a retrospective study. We selected 70 cases with presumed healthy eyes prior to trauma between the duration of Jan 2012 to 2015. The contralateral, the other eye normal is served as a control. The exclusion criteria were unilateral axial length record, primary or secondary glaucoma, duration of trauma less than 1 year, bilateral trauma or a congenital cataract. We formed two groups. We defined blunt and penetrating according to Betts classification. Age at injury, mode, nature and interval since injury was documented. The best corrected visual acuity, refractive error, intraocular pressure, keratometry, biometric values of both eyes were documented and analyzed. So these are the various tests which used for statistical analysis. The results were out of the 70 cases, 13 cases were aphakic, 14 cases were had traumatic cataract and 43 were pseudophakic. As we can see, penetrating were 47 and rest were blunt trauma, rest 23. Compared to male and female, the number of cases were obviously more in male as compared to female. In both the gender, penetrating was more than blunt trauma. These were the results of the mean axial length. As we can see in penetrating trauma, the axial length was around 25.31, the mean axial length. In blunt, it was around 24.05. So as we can see, it was more in penetrating as compared to blunt. It was seen both in males and females. Comparing the axial length using the injury, the age at injury, if it is less than 15 years, then the axial length was around 25.81. Whereas in blunt, around it was around 24.24. That means in both penetrating and blunt, younger the age, the axial length elongation was more. This was the final table which we calculated that how much is the axial length increasing in traumatic eye as compared to the normal eye. So we use regression analysis. So we got this factor 1.34. So if a person is having elongation of 1 mm in a normal eye, we could found that this is the factor which is increasing. 1.34 will be the axial length more in the traumatic eye. There are other factors also which were also statistically significant, which showed that these are the factors which are responsible for axial length elongation. This is a scatter plot showing the comparison between blunt and penetrating trauma. As we can see, the age, as younger the age, more is the difference in the more is the axial length. As we and the upper line shows the penetrating and lower is the blunt. So in penetrating, it is more increasing as compared to the blunt. This is the second graph. It shows the difference between the two axial length, that is the control eye and the traumatic eye. As we can see, in penetrating, again the axial length elongation is more as compared to the blunt. And as the age progresses, the length also increases. Coming to discussion, there are multiple mechanisms which have been postulated. It could be trauma, age at surgery, duration, severity of visual deprivation, amblyopia, IOP changes, changes in scleral rigidity, multiple surgeries. Both trauma and visual deprivation has been confounding factor for axial length elongation, but the actual cause still remains elusive. This is the data which is compared with various studies. These are not the traumatic cataract, but say, but most of them have not studied the axial length. They have studied the IOL power miscalculation, whatever it is. So what we have compared the data, all the authors have found that the axial length elongation was more in traumatic eye as compared to the normal eye. In our cases, we had 70 cases. Most of the other studies, they don't have more than around 20 cases. As we can see, it is, as I mentioned earlier, it was more in penetrating as compared to blunt. And it was shown in other studies as well that the axial length elongation is more in traumatic cases. We tried to reliably extract the data regarding the interval from injury to the time of presentation or surgery in most of the cases based on the records. Regression analysis of the data was proved that the increase in axial length in traumatic is greater as compared to the normal eye. Hence, we are able to establish a correlation between the degree of elongation and the interval between trauma and surgery statistically. Limitations of our study that the two eyes of each patient were similar to prior to injury, we have assumed that. Much variability in the post-operative refractive changes that we have to consider. Predicting exactly when and where the refraction will stabilize in each case for is very difficult. Predicting the appropriate IOL power is also difficult with degree of accuracy, that how, when it will stabilize. So in conclusion, trauma leading to visual depression may cause unilateral axial length elongation. Elongation of eyeball is significantly greater in penetrating as compared to blunt. Younger the patient, greater the magnitude of axial length elongation, and longer the duration between the trauma and presentation, greater will be the axial length in the traumatic. These are the references. Thank you.
In the post-op follow-up, do you feel that after 2 years, 3 years, or 5 years, the elongation process gets slowed down if they get a particular visual acuity, or it's?
What we have found out, that we have not studied the patient for a long duration, sir. We have, from the trauma till the presentation, we have studied that part only. We have not monitored the axial length, that how much it is increasing or decreasing. We just analyzed the retrospective data, that when the patient had injury and when it was presented. So
anything like cutoff, that the vision like this, 624 or less, or 618 or less, will have more elongation?
Actually, we have not studied that part, sir. But what we have concluded is that more the duration, younger the.
That is known. What is the new?
So what we have, we just
that
wanted
is known
to
everyone.
Yeah.
That if you have more period, then elongation will be more.
Yes, sir.
But what is new?
So we studied that part only, sir. We just okay. We
anything to do with like the trauma before 2 years of age or before 4 years of age have a definite difference.
I have shown that if it is younger the age, the chances of
no younger and older is a relative word. I am saying, can you put like this 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, any cutoff age in which there is a gross difference?
No, sir, I have not.
Okay, I think that should be better because it is a non-fact.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.